वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास। नेटवर्किंग कॉन्सेप्ट, सो वी आर ऑन सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन। फर्स्ट लेसन, वन मोर पार्ट विल बी देयर दैट वी विल बी डूइंग, मे बी इन टू और थ्री डेज ड्यूरेशन। आई विल सेंड यू द थर्ड पार्ट एंड द फर्स्ट लेसन नोट्स ऑल्सो आई विल बी सेंडिंग यू। ओके, सो लास्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन द इंट्रोडक्शन, कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स, एडवांटेजेस ऑफ नेटवर्किंग एंड यू कैन से डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ नेटवर्किंग, देन सिक्योरिटी इश्यूज, एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ यू कैन से कंप्यूटर्स, एटलीस्ट टू और मोर than two computers, not or workstations or terminals. So generally you will find it can be maybe more than two, or you can say workstations or terminals, maybe one building to other building. So there we are using what you can say networks. Now there are different kinds of networks, even that we are going to see. First one is you can say PAN. Okay, when we talk about PAN, that is personal area network. Now what exactly is personal area network? Okay, it is a computer network used to communicate communication among computerized device. Okay, so it is generally you can say a computerized device, which you can say can be used, including you can say the telephone, personal digital assistants. PANs can be used for communication among the personal devices themselves, that is intrapersonal communication. For example, you can say intercoms, Wi-Fi connections are there, or connecting to a higher level network and the internet, okay, uplink. So they, for this purpose we are using PAN, that is personal area network. You can see one picture I have shown you. So one, you can say network can connect to different things. It can be iPad, it can be a mobile phone, headphone, mouse, wireless, you can say printer, wireless laptop. Okay, so best example, Wi-Fi, you can give example in that. Next network comes, that is local area network. Now in local area network, what generally you see, the computer network that interconnects computer in a limited area such as home, school, computer, library or office building using network media. LANs, that is local area network, normally do not exceed an area of 2 or 3 square kilometers. Again I repeat, LAN, you can say that normally do not exceed an area of 2 or 3 square kilometers. The PCs and the network peripheral mostly use copper wires or wireless link for communication, as all the PCs are located in a building. The speed of communication is good and the communication error and data loss is less. So these are, you can say, fun features of local area network. Here also you can see one picture I am showing you. Now floppy disk we are not using, it is outdated one. Okay, we in place of that we are using CD drive. The CDs and DVDs we are using. So we are not using floppies nowadays. So you can see here different computers and printers are connected to, you can say, LAN. Third one, MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. Now you can see your office building, residential area, government building, universities, different places. Okay, it can cover one full area. Okay, and in that area we can use MAN. Okay, so you can say that it is more effective compared to PAN and you can say LAN. Okay, next one, the most important one, that is WAN, that is wide area network. Okay, so wide area network, you can say that a large geographical area of a country or you can say a continent. this type of networks uses a variety of, you can say, commercial and private communication lines to connect computers. Your telephone exchange is a WAN. Best example I can give you is the telephone exchange. Okay, the telephones which we are getting is because of WAN only. Sometimes satellites are also used to connect computer in a WAN. The internet is an example of a widely use of WAN. We connect to people from one country to other countries just because of wide area network. Okay. Next, you can see protocol. Now, when we talk about protocol, so what exactly it is? Okay. When computers communicate with each other, there needs to be a common set of rules and instructions that each computer follows. A specific set of communication rules is called a protocol. There are, you can say, large number of protocols that can be used in a network depending upon needs they fulfill. Some of the protocols are discussed here. Okay, so we are going to see two type of protocol. Generally, these are very commonly used. Okay, HTTP, we are very familiar. Even when you're typing any website name, once that website is open, you see there, you will find this HTTP is there. Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is an internet protocol responsibility to for transferring and displaying web pages. It gives a way for web clients and web server to communicate with each other by sending and receiving messages. Second one, every computer got this TCP and IP, okay? Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. Without TCP and IP, your computer is not going to connect with any kind of, you can say, internet or modem, right? So Transmission Control Protocol, TCP, is one of the core, you can say, or important protocol of the internet protocol suites, that is IP, and is so common that the entire suit is often called TCP/IP. The TCP is responsible for dividing the message or file in the same, you can say, packet, and at the core computer that are transmitted over the network. It reassembles the packets into original message or file at the destination computer. During transmission process, if any packet is lost, it is demanded again. So generally, every computer you will find, there is one TCP and IP. So generally, where you find this, just right click on network neighborhood and go in the properties, and you can check out your TCP and IP numbers will be there. Okay. So every computer has the TCP and IP. Next, you will find intranet and internet. When we talk about intranet and internet, the term intra means within, and extranet, that is outside. Okay. So within and outside. So intranet means within a network. Intranet is a network within a particular organization with some general as well as confidential information. This information is distributed in the form of web page meant on for employee or organizational policies. Open discussion topics, form, training materials, etc. It can be used for different all these purposes. Extranet is a computer network that allows control access from the outside. For specific business or educational purpose, in a business to business contact, an extranet can be viewed as an extension of an organization. Intranet that is extended to user outside the organization, usually partners, suppliers, shareholders, customers, vendors, etc. in isolation from all other internet users, outsiders can access the extranet only if they have a valid username and password, and they can access only a part of extranet based on their identity. Okay, so nowadays online many things you can see. Okay, especially in corona time, you will find that many things are happening online. Online classes are there. If you have the ID and password only, then you can enter the meeting. Otherwise, you cannot, right? So one example of extranet. Then network, you can see network devices. In that you will find hub. Now, hub is a small box that connects the individual device on a network so that they can communicate with one another. It's known as a hub or Ethernet hub. A hub is basically a multi-port device that range in size from 4 ports to several hundred ports. So the minimum 4 and maximum it can go several hundreds. The signal from the individual device are gathered and connected to the network with, you can say, retransmit them to all other connected device. So generally hub is used to transfer your, you can say, connection from one PC to multiple PC. So hub is helping you. One server computer connection, all the wires in the hub, and from hub it is transferring to all the computers. Best example, our computer lab, school computer lab, you see one server is there inside the room. That room hub is there. In that hub, all 50, you can say, computer, you can say it is connected. So server is giving you the access to use internet connection. Okay, so in that hub plays an important role. Next part, modem. Now, when we talk about a modem, you can also call it as modulator or demodulator. Is a device that modulates an analog, you can say, carrier signal to encode digital information and also demodulate such a carrier signal to decode the transmitted information. The goal is to produce a signal that can be transmitted easily and decode it to reproduce the original digital data. So modem plays a very important role. We all are having at home. Okay, it can be of different companies and different color, but the feature is same. Without proper, you can say, connection, you can't access internet. Next one is Ethernet card. Now, the most popular high-speed LAN technology is the Ethernet card. These are reasonably priced. The Ethernet can transmit and receive data at the speed of 100 Mbps. So this speed is normal nowadays in any normal PC, 100 Mbps. The computers that are part of Ethernet have to be used a special card called Ethernet card. Connection for either, you can say, coaxial or twisted wire cables or both is connected by this card. This both the, you can say, twisted wire and coaxial, we are going to see further because it is there in data communication. So that we are going to see in detail. Even the picture I will be showing you people, right? Usually Ethernet cards are purchased separately for a computer. But these days, most computers provide an option for a pre-installed Ethernet card. That means computer who's assembling, he's already giving you an option that before you purchase separately, they give you an option to purchase it same time and they install it same time, right? So next time we are going to see about the data communication and communication device, in that wire networking technology, where we are going to see about the coaxial and twisted wire. Same time wireless networking also we are going to see. So these three topics are remaining to complete our first lesson. Our lessons is lengthy because total 17 pages are there. I'm remaining with 3 more pages. So next time, maybe in 1 or 2 days time, again I will upload the third part of the first lesson. Same time I will upload the notes of the first lesson. Okay, after that, second and third lesson is very small. It is based on HTML. So we are going to complete that two lessons little faster compared to the first lesson. So stay home, be safe, and we will meet again in few days time.